Happy Valentine's Day, everybody. It's Fran Harrison. Welcome to my special February 14th webinar. I love my business. 14 things you should do in 2013 to grow your brand. Now, I've got 14 minutes to deliver 14 tactics or principles that will help you grow your brand or business or your company this year. So let's get cracking. Fasten your seatbelts. We're about to get going. Number one, become more positive and less cynical. You've heard it before. It's a cliche because it's true. The people who are more positive in the world and less cynical in the world are ultimately people who are more successful. You can look at those folks, whether it's in your personal life or it's in your people you work with. People who are more positive, who see the silver lining, who see the possibilities instead of the limitations of things that are out there in their lives, are typically more successful than people who are very negative, who are always looking for somebody's hidden agenda. Just become more positive. Just make a conscious decision to become more positive and watch what happens in your life. Number two, pick three. I'm not talking about the lotto. I'm talking about picking three people you want to follow in 2013. Okay, so sometimes these are people who you aspire to be like personally or professionally or financially. Pick three people who are doing what you want to do in some area of your life and just follow them. Just stick with it for 1 year or 6 months and follow them. There are people that I pick at the beginning of each year and I go, okay, I like what this guy is doing, or I like what this woman is doing. I'm going to watch her for a quarter. I'm going to watch him for 6 months, or I'm going to watch them for a year, and just watch and see what makes these people successful. See what makes them separate themselves in the marketplace. And again, this doesn't have to be business related. It doesn't have to be financially related. It could be just people you admire, people who are moving in ways that you want to move in or going places where you want to go. Pick three, stay with them for a designated period of time and watch what happens to you in your own life. Number three, microblog. The great thing about Twitter is that it gives us the opportunity to put little bits of information and our expertise and our advice into the world. So if you're an expert or an entrepreneur or an author or something like that, rather than having to commit to writing a 500 or 700 word article and putting it on a blog, what you can do by using Twitter or Facebook is what's called microblogging. So it's little bitty bursts of your advice or your expertise that you can put out there and start building your audience. What's great about it is that it doesn't require people to make a huge commitment to you, right? I don't have to sit down and read a 3-page article that you've written to get a sense for who you are or what you're about. I can read a 20-word burst or 140-word, 140-character burst on Twitter and get connected to you. The thing you want to do with your microblogging, of course, is send people to where they can read more. So microblogging gives you the opportunity to kind of give us an appetizer as to who you are and then send us to a link where we can learn more about you. So make sure you commit to microblogging. Number four, set a big goal. This goal is so big that when you tell people about it, they're going to say, you got to be crazy. Nobody like you has ever done anything like that, okay? Set a huge goal. For me, there are goals that you can set that are tiny goals. The goals that really stretch you and kind of reveal who you are those huge goals that most people are so afraid of making because they're so afraid that people are going to tell them that they can't do it. Guess what? I think you need people to tell you that you can't do stuff. I mean, it's great to have people in your life who are saying, yeah, you can do it. Those people are great. I have lots of those people in my life. But what's real is to tell people about a huge goal that you have and to hear those people say, there's no way you're going to be able to do that. Okay? That's when who you are and the character that you possess really comes into play. And it kind of reveals whether, you know, how badly you want your goal. So set a big goal. Watch what happens in the process of attempting to achieve that goal. And remember, you need both sides of the coin. You need people who are saying you can absolutely do it, and you need people who are not believing in themselves and therefore they're projecting that disbelief onto you. Set a big goal and go for it. Do a live online event. You can use services like Livestream or Livecast to do an event in real time. And I discovered this probably 7 or 8 years ago when I'd attempted to do an event in person and then the weather wouldn't allow us to do the event, and we started to explore whether we could do the event via the internet and discovered these wonderful tools out there that allow you to do exactly what I'm doing right now, which is to share your expertise, to share your advice, to share an event live online, and people can watch it either through their mobile phones or through their computer. Okay, do a live event, great way to expand your brand. Number, wherever we are, what are we, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6. We're going to learn something new. The great thing about the internet is that it's given us the opportunity to learn things, to have access to things that are right at our fingertip, right? So learning something new can be something like a skill, or it can be a new craft or an art or something like that. But nothing has really inspired me more than having the opportunity to learn something that I probably hadn't planned on learning or probably hadn't planned on doing. Learn something new. It's great for building confidence. It also gives you the ability to stretch yourself in ways that you probably have never thought about. And I'm not talking about learning something new like, oh, I'm going to learn a new business skill, although that's kind of cool. But I mean, learn something drastically different, something that is so far away from things that you might have thought about doing that it just gives you a completely newfound sense of identity. So learn something new and make sure you learn something new before this year is over. Next, do something daring, okay? Kind of the cousin of learning something new. Do something daring. Do something that is so far beyond, and this can be in your business since that's what we're talking about. You know, if you market a certain way, if there's a certain way that you've been marketing your brand, or there's a certain way you've been doing your video, then consider doing something that's so different that it just shocks people. It's like, did Fran Harris just do that? Did she just do that? Do something completely daring that people will stand up and take notice. Is it in the way that you deliver your audio? Is it in the way that you speak or the way you introduce yourself as a speaker? Is it in the way that you write your books? What is it? Do something daring that will separate you in the marketplace and cause people to take notice. Next, host a webinar. Depending on when you're seeing this I Love My Business webinar, it could be live, it could be taped, but webinars, just like live online events, give you the opportunity to share your experience and your expertise without being chained to your desk, right? You can do webinars either live, so you're literally teaching a class, kind of like I'm doing right now, or you can do a webinar and then automate it so that you're not having to be at your desk or your computer at a specific time in the busyness of your day. That's what's great about the internet, right? You can share your expertise. You can do your coaching. You can do it either live. You can do it at 6 o'clock at night when you're, you know, coming home from your other job, if you have one. You can do it at 10 o'clock in the morning, because that's when the people that you serve are actually available to learn from you. Okay. So host a webinar this year. Next, commit to anonymous kindness. Every month I feel like I have to do something. I have to have a random act of kindness. And I'd like for it to be anonymous, because I don't really think people need to know always that you're doing stuff good for them, right? I know that sometimes people do things because they want people to know that they've done things. They donate money because they want their name on the wall or whatever. And I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that. I'm saying watch the kind of joy that you get when you commit an anonymous act of kindness, right? Just last month, someone was going through something very difficult, and you know, people were contributing to the situation, and I thought that was great, but I wasn't interested in contributing and having it necessarily be known that I did whatever I did. So I made my contribution and I took my name off of it, and it was just a cool feeling, right? So think about the opportunities that you have during the day to commit random acts of anonymous kindness. Next, give up an unproductive habit. We've all got unproductive habits. We've all got things that we need to stop doing that are not moving us closer to where we want to be, whether it's physically, you know, it could be losing weight, or it could be smoking, or it could be nastiness. It could be a personality flaw, whatever it is. Give up something that really is quite unproductive. It's not moving you toward a better relationship with your spouse, or it's not moving you toward a more productive day in terms of your job. It's not moving you closer to your financial goals. What is the unproductive habit that's keeping you from where or what you want in your life? Give it up. Write an ebook. You know, another thing that the internet gives us an opportunity to do is to become published authors. 10, 15, 20 years ago, if you wanted to publish a book, you had to get a literary agent. That took forever. You had to write a book proposal, and then you had to wait a year or two for them to publish your book. No longer is the case, right? With Amazon and Kindle and just your own website, you can publish your book on any topic you want, nonfiction, fiction, whatever, poetry. Write an ebook and you can publish it within 24 hours. You can publish it within an hour. Okay. There really are no excuses for people who say, I've always wanted to write a book. Well, now you've got the opportunity to write a book and publish it. All you need is an account, a PayPal account, write it, convert it to a PDF, and get it done. All right. Start an online business. Again, everything is kind of revolving around our ability to do things virtually and online. Start an online business will allow you to, whether it's sharing your coaching or if you are a therapist and you want to do online therapy, yes, people do that. If you are a construction worker and you want to show people how to do this, if you're a mechanic and you want to show people how to fix their cars, if you're a speaker and you want to spread your message, if you're a minister and you want to witness to people, whatever it is you want to do, you can do it through the power of the internet. And you can, there's an exchange for it. You know, people talk about, well, I don't know if I should charge money for my gift. Well, here's my take on that. If you are giving people something, there is always going to be an exchange. So if you're sharing your gift and they're receiving your gift, what's wrong with them exchanging their money for your gift? Okay. The internet, again, great opportunity to just start an online business where you are sharing your expertise. I call it making dough for what you know. Sharing your expertise, or heck, selling some old stuff that you got. You got some old stuff that other people want, furniture, electronics, books. You can do all of that online. A great place to start is Amazon. Amazon will sell your virtual goods and products, and they'll sell your physical stuff using eBay. You can do all kinds of things. But consider looking online and figuring out how you can start your own online business. It's the one place. It completely is an equalizer in the marketplace. You don't need a lot of money to start an online business. Just look around online for what you want to do. And I guarantee you there's somebody out there who's doing it, who's already starting an online business, and you can do it as well. All right, wake up tomorrow and sing or dance. I mean, when is the last time you really just woke up joyfully? I want you to wake up tomorrow. After listening to this video, wake up tomorrow and just start singing. Just start singing. I mean, or wake up, jump out of bed, and just start dancing. That's what I want you to do. Really, I want you to wake up tomorrow and sing, or wake up tomorrow and dance. The first thing out of your mouth, just sing your favorite song, whatever song comes to your mind. Or wake up, when your feet hit the floor, just start dancing. And just take note of a difference, of the difference that you feel just from doing something as spontaneous and unpredictable as singing or dancing the moment your eyes are open. All right? I do it and it's quite fun. And then finally, make sure you are taking advantage of the free monthly classes that I'm offering through Fran Harris University. You know, there's so many things. The reason I started Fran Harris University was to share the expertise in the areas, you know, for over the last 20, 25 years, whether it's sales or speaking or writing or publishing or screenwriting or filmmaking, I mean, just so many different things people would ask me to share my expertise on. And I said I needed one kind of platform, really, just kind of a platform to be able to share everything so that you guys weren't going running all over to 30 different websites to figure out what it is. And finally, you know, duh, kind of hit me. Start your own online university. And that's what we've done. So make sure that you've signed up at franharrisuniversity.com and gotten on the list, and you will get notified of new classes almost every single week and sometimes several times a week. All right. Hope you have a great Valentine's Day. Show lots of love. Show the world who you are. And I'll see you at another Fran Harris University event. Take good care.